Hey guys, it's Noelle. In this Plan With Me series, I've been showing you a ton of different ways to plan out your life in your bullet journal, from your schoolwork to your after-school activities. But one thing I haven't touched on is how to plan parties in your bullet journal. And when birthday season comes around, your bullet journal can serve as a great resource to get all your party planning ducks in a row. So I'm gonna show you some great ideas for spreads to help you plan your next birthday party. But before I get into it, definitely subscribe to 17's YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any of our future bullet journaling tips and tricks. All right, let's go. For the purpose of this video, I'm gonna be planning a Sweet 16, but you can use the following spreads to plan any type of party. It doesn't have to be a birthday party. It can be a homecoming party or a going away party. Anything. For the first party planning layout, I thought it would be a great idea to have an opening page to kind of set the tone of your next few party planning pages. So I did a kind of opening spread for party planning. I started by drawing two strings across the top of the page and then drew little flags on them to look kind of festive and birthday party-like. I colored them in alternating between pink and purple, which is a super easy doodle to make your page look really festive and fun. Then I wrote Sweet 16 in big fun hand lettering and gave it a pink drop shadow. Then I took my pink and purple gel pens and drew out some stars and dots to make it look like confetti is falling from the sky. Now we have set the tone and the page already feels super Sweet 16-y, but now we have to add the pertinent information for our party. So I took my pink marker and wrote out theme, date, time, where, and budget. Then all you have to do is fill in those categories with the information for your party. I decided for this Sweet 16, it's gonna be a pretty small Sweet 16 with a Riverdale theme, since I'm obsessed with the show Riverdale. And it's gonna be on April 19th from 8 p.m. to midnight. And it'll be at my house. And the budget is $250. When you're planning anything, it's super important to have a checklist. So the next page is gonna be a simple party checklist so that you make sure you dot all your I's and cross all your T's. I decided to try to get a little fancy with this page. I took my dark pink water-based marker and colored a little spot of dark pink onto my ruler. And then I took my light pink marker and rolled it through the color so that the light marker picks up the color of the dark marker. I just went and wrote party checklist in nice calligraphy. And as you can see, the method of blending the two colors created a sort of automatic gradient in the title that looks really pretty with the two shades of pink. And then all you have to do is write down a checklist of all the things that you have to get done before your party. I wrote things like finalize guest lists and send invites, buy decorations with a bullet list of the decorations that I'll need and so forth. And that's it. All you have to do is check off everything that you get done as you go. Next, every party needs a guest list. For my guest list page, I decided to give the page a little birthday feel by drawing out my dream cake in the bottom right corner. And I colored the cake in gold and blue because those are the Riverdale colors. After I colored in my cake, I moved on to the title of the page. I wrote out guest list in big pink letters and outlined it with my black pen. And then after that, I wrote out my guest list with all my friends that will be receiving an invitation from moi in the coming days. Then I created two checkboxes by each name by coloring in the corners of each square. And that's just a little twist on a regular checkbox to kind of bring your layout to the next level. Then I took my purple gel pen and created a box with rounded corners around the whole list. Then I labeled the columns of checkboxes, and then if they RSVP, color in that checkbox as well. Next is another super simple layout, a budget page. All I did for this was write out budget in big black calligraphy. And then after that, you should write down a list of all the things that you know you'll have to buy and estimate how much they'll cost. Along the way, I wrote what each one could possibly cost on the right side. Then under everything, I wrote total and added up the expenses to $185. Last but not least, I thought the page looked a little plain, so I drew out my two strings with purple and pink flags on either side of the title. Finally, you cannot have a party without a playlist, especially if it's a Riverdale party, since they sing nonstop on that show. So I'm gonna put together a party playlist. All I did for this page was write playlist in big bold letters across the top of the page, and then used my gel pen to create some pink musical notes on either side. Then I numbered the page 1 through 15. After that, I just filled it in with songs that I'd want to play at the party, and obviously I'm keeping it Riverdale inspired, so I included Tell Me by Johnny Jewel from the first episode of the show, Dance 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 by the Riverdale cast, and the Carrie playlist, which was amazing in the musical episode. This party is gonna be lit. That's it. I hope these party planning spreads help you plan the best party ever. Now definitely subscribe to 17's YouTube channel below so that you don't miss out on any of our future bullet journaling videos just like this one. Bye.